Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Najwa Husseini with Azadi News. We would rather die now than be kept here forever, said Rohingya. UN chief calls for a resolution of Rohingya refugee crisis. The Rohingya are as far from home today as they were 3 years ago on 25th August, when they were violently expelled from their homeland. Exactly 3 years ago, Burmese soldiers accompanied by local Buddhist militias launched a wave of attacks on Rohingya villages in the northwest corner of the Southeast Asian country. More than a million Rohingya genocide survivors, most fled in the 2017 violence, find themselves dislocated in what has become a never-ending road to justice for the world's most persecuted religious minority. On the morning of 25th August 2017, tens of thousands Rohingya awoke to the sound of gunfire and mortar rounds aimed at their villages and homes. The wave of violence, including mass killings, gang rapes, looting and property destruction that would continue for 3 bloody months. By the start of December, more than 20,000 Rohingya were dead alongside thousands more injured and permanently traumatized, according to estimates made by Doctors Without Borders. One study documented 18,000 incidences of rape, 35,000 being thrown into a fire, and 42,000 gunshot wounds. An international collaborative research effort, which included interviews with 3,300 Rohingya households living in refugee camps alongside the Burma-Bangladesh border, reveals the full scale of atrocities carried out against the Rohingya in the final months of 2017. 97% witnessed their neighbors injured by Burmese authorities. 82% witnessed their neighbors' death or saw dead bodies in Myanmar before fleeing. 59% witnessed neighbors being raped by Burmese authorities. 85% witnessed the burning of their own home. Nearly 1 million Rohingya remain trapped in squalid refugee camps on the Burma-Bangladesh border, with a further 200,000 trapped in Arakan State, or what a Rohingya village leader in Burma described to me as a genocide zone, cornered by Burmese soldiers on one side and Arakan separatist fighters on the other, with thousands of landmines in between. Rohingya refugees will not return until they are guaranteed security citizenship, reparations, and an end to discriminatory policies, with the perpetrators of the genocide brought to justice. UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres on Tuesday highlighted the Rohingya refugee crisis on the third anniversary of the mass exodus from Burma to Bangladesh. The Secretary General renewed his call to bring greater urgency to this crisis by addressing the root causes of the conflict and creating the conditions for the safe, voluntary, dignified, and sustainable return for all refugees, according to Stephane Dujarric, Guterres' spokesman. The ultimate responsibility rests with Burmese authorities. Beyond solutions for the immediate humanitarian suffering, accountability is an imperative for long-term reconciliation, the spokesman said in a statement. The United Nations will continue to stand in solidarity with all those affected by the crisis and is committed to working with all stakeholders, including regional actors, toward a future of sustainable development, human rights, and peace in Arakan State and all of Burma, it said. This is today's news. To get more updates about Rohingya, subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the notification bell. Visit our website azadinews.org and follow our social media accounts. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.